Why did Shorty Longbottom have a pink Spitfire? Who? Ooh.
It was puffed.
It was, say again.
Puffed.
Puffed.
It was puffed out, yes.
Oh, I see.
It was exhausted from its exertions.
Oh, I see. Thank God for that. I was worried for a moment that we'd strayed into territory that just wasn't quite right somehow. Actually, it was a pretty new one. It was a very light one. It was a very special one.
Did he check Hindus out on a weekend? You know, when the war slowed down?
Yeah, it got dull.
Some lass with an old plate on. Did he get her in the back and take her out town?
What were the female members of the RAF? What were they called?
Wrens.
Wafts.
Wafts. And called, how would you know that?
Because I was one.
Oh, we seem to be in your territory again.
Yeah, well, I joined the Women's Royal Air Force and I went to Singapore and Germany and I had a very nice time.
Excellent. That's very good to know.
You should do recruiting.
You should.
Actually, I've always been looking for the recruiting sergeant with the bread knife, as a matter of fact, because he said to me, what do you like doing? And I said, drawing. And he put me in a drawing office, you know, which was all maths and technical drawing and that, and I couldn't do it.
What a bad man.
Evil.
You did that to me at school. They said, what do you want to do? I said, maths. They put me in a maths class.
No.
I mean, can you believe that?
Oh, that's not good enough.
Well, I was obviously built for dancing. Just outrageous.
What's your drawing anything to do with aerial photographs?
That sort of thing. And I can give you a little bit of inside info here.
Go on. If
you are studying aerial photography and you see a photograph which contains a cricket pitch and you happen to know the focal length of the camera, you can calculate the scale.
Brilliant. I thought you were going to say calculate the score then.
Because you know a cricket pitch is 22 yards, therefore... Yeah. But obviously, presumably, when the Spitfire's flying over Germany, the Germans are the kind of utter swine who won't play cricket.
So it was tricky if you didn't have a cricket pitch on the photograph.
Right. But suppose in the early days of the war you wanted to send an aeroplane over to take photographs.
Some sort of disguise, camouflage.
Camouflage is the right answer.
Pink skies or pink...
Yeah, actually, they made it blue and that stood out. And there it is. Shorty Longbottom's pink Spitfire.
Well, if he did get spotted when it was taking pictures, wouldn't the other planes just naturally flirt with it?
You'd think this would be the big
disadvantage. The pilots would abandon the dogfighting skills and just go, hello. Came back from the dam busters thing, pregnant.
Well, it certainly shows you've got to love your country to be prepared to go up in one of those. But when it's a cloudy day, the sky has a sort of pink tinge
pink
to it when it's cloudy.
Pink tone, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Or alternatively, if you wanted to camouflage your aircraft, you could paint it as a ship.
Yes.
It was at that point that Ayres was asked to leave the RAF.
Yes. Exactly.
The whole of Germany turned into that bloke from the Love and Hardy films. Booze away.
Exactly.
Stephen, I must point out, I can't hear anything you say. So I'm just...
You're welcome to stay like that or take it off.
If the show's going well, let me keep talking.
Yeah, OK. Well, there we are. Reconnaissance Spitfires were painted pink to match the clouds.